Hi, welcome to this series of JasperSoft reports. In this video, we are going to see the basics of variables in JasperSoft Design Studio. The agenda for this session is, firstly, I will walk you through what are variables and their usage. Then we take a look at the properties of the variable. And finally, we will see an example on how to create a variable and use it in a report. Let's get started. What are variables and their usage? A variable in Jasper report is a container to store a value or a result based on the data retrieved from the database. Variables are generally used in complex calculation or in calculating the other variables. Variable is a reporting object in the studio, and we represent it with $V here. Now, let us take a look at the properties of a variable. Every variable that we create in a report will get a name, class name, calculation, expression, initial value expression, increment type, incrementer factory class name, reset type. We can consider name, class name, calculation, expression, initial value expression are the base properties of a variable. The available functions for calculation are sum, average, count, lowest, and highest. There are several other functions available for the calculation. Now, let's have a look at the advanced properties of a variable. We can consider increment type and reset type are the advanced properties of a variable. Let us briefly look at what is increment type and what is reset type. Increment type. Increment type is an advanced attribute of a variable. It is basically used to change the time on which the calculation function is used. The possible values for the increment type are none, report, page, and column. And we also have additional increment type, that is group. Increment type calculation is based on the expression. That means when a calculation function is defined, the expression is passed on to the function, and the function will do the calculation for the variable. The default behavior is to do the calculation at every record level. We use increment types on the functions. If we select increment type as none, the calculation function is called for each record that we retrieve from the database. If we select the increment type as report, the calculation function is called at the end of the report. And if we select the increment type as page, the calculation function is called at the end of the each page. And similarly, if we select increment type as column, the calculation function is called at the end of the each column. And if we select the additional increment type, which is group, then the calculation function is called at the start of the every occurrence of the group specified. It is visible in the dropdown if the report is having at least one group created. Now let's briefly look at what is reset type. Reset type is another advanced property of a variable. It is basically used to define when to reset the value of a variable to its initial value. We generally use reset type on the group by summations. The possible values for the reset type are none, report, page, column, and group by. If we select reset type as none, the variable will never get be initialized. That means the initial value expression will be ignored. If we select reset type as report, the variable is initialized at the start of the report creation. And if we select reset type as page, the variable is initialized at the each page. If we select reset type as column, the variable is initialized on each new column. If we select reset type as group, the variable is initialized at the start of every occurrence of the report. Again, it is visible. That means the group is visible in the dropdown for the reset type if the report contains at least one group. Now it is time to create a variable and use that variable in a report. Let us take the scenario of a product detail report. Now it's time to create a report in the studio. Create a blank report from file, new, Jasper report. Select blank A4 template from the report templates wizard. Click on next button and let's give a name for this report. I am taking variables and sum of a column, product detail report, as the report name here. Let's save this report under Jasper Reports 2021 folder. And I already have a folder, subfolder called as reports. I am going to save this report in reports folder. Then click on next. From the data adapter dropdown, select the FoodMart database. Let's keep providing query for now. So click on either next or finish button to have the report design view ready. Click OK, click finish. Now in the PG Admin SQL editor, query the product table with product ID, product name, gross weight, and net weight fields. Let's quickly run this query to view the result set in the bottom. So we have now a total of 11 records, and we are going to find the total for the net weight column in the report by creating a variable. So let's copy this query and paste it in the SQL editor of the studio. Copy it here. We need to ensure that the FoodMart database is selected from the top left dropdown, and the language type must be SQL. Now click on read field button, and in the bottom, we can see field name and class types are retrieved from the database. Now from the bottom menu, just click on data preview and then click on refresh preview data so that we can see the sample records retrieved from the database. Click OK, then save the report. Now from the hierarchical view of the outline, select fields, expand it, and select all the fields from the fields node and drag it on to the detail band. Let's quickly format this report to not to have any empty spaces and also remove the unnecessary bands from the report. We need to have the column footer where we are going to place the variable that we are going to create. So let's keep the column footer available in the design space. Now let's add a title to the report. Static text from the palette, then give the same name that we use it for saving the report. That is variables and sum of a column for product detail report. So title is given. Click finish, then adjust the width of the text field. And let's remove the empty space from the title band. We don't require this page header band here. So let's remove this one. Quickly adjust the heights of the text field, horizontally and vertically middle. Now we have the report ready, which will look like a grid format. Let's give border to all of them. Properties from border and select all borders for this one. Let's preview this report and run it. Click on preview button from the bottom tabs, then click on run button. Now we have the product detail report ready with us. Now we are going to create a variable to find the total of the net weight field. So we reached to the core part of creating a variable in the report. For that, from the hierarchical outline view, select variables, right click on it, then click on create variable. By default, variable underscore one is created. And if you look at the properties of this variable, we can have name, value class name, then the calculation. By default, it is no calculation function. Let's change this calculation from no calculation function to sum. And let's also replace this variable underscore one to a meaningful name, something like variable total net weight. That was a suggestion because I already have created a variable in some other report. So let's name it as variable total net weight. And we need to provide the expression for this variable. We are going to find the total for the net weight column. So let's give the expression as net weight. Open the expression editor and then select net weight field. Click on finish. By default, when we create a variable, the increment type is none and the reset type is report. Let's do not change these values for now for this demonstration. Now, select the variable total net weight that we just created from the variable node and drag it onto the column footer just beneath through the net weight field. So we are done here. We just created a variable and we pull out that variable onto the column footer band. Let's quickly run this report and see what it outputs. Before running, let's quickly format this one. Select save, click on preview and run the report. Looks like we have some error generated. JR fill expression, error evaluating expression for source text. Let's go back to the design view and see what the error was. So here, the error is related to the type of the variable. By default, when we create a variable, it takes the string type. Let's change this to float. Let's match the type of this variable to the type of what on what field we are creating the variable. So in this case, the type of net weight field is float. So we need to match the same type to the variable. Select the report and run it again. Click preview. So now we have the product detail report displayed. And if we scroll down to the bottom, we can see the total for the net weight field is displayed here. So this is how we can create a variable for a report and we can make use of that report in the column footer band to calculate the summation of a particular column. I would like to tell you that there is an easiest way to create a variable. For example, if we want to calculate the total for gross weight fields from the field section, just select the particular field, which is gross weight in this case, and drag it onto the column footer just beneath to the gross weight column. So as we drag that field, it opens up a text field wizard, which contains the possible functions that we can apply on the field. So let's take sum here and click on finish. As we drop this function here onto the column footer band, the report will generate a variable with the field name in the variable section. Let's have a look at the properties of this one. So the name is given as cross weight one. Then the value class name is taken as float by default. Then we have selected some while dragging and dropping the gross weight field. And the expression is taken as $f gross weight. And by default, increment type is taken as none and reset type as column. So this is another alternative to create a report. If we closely look at the properties of the created variable and the properties of generated variable, we can understand that the reset type is column for the generated one, and the reset type for the created one by default is report. Let's do not worry about how these are appearing for the created and the generated fields. As we get command on the variables, we can easily understand how effectively we can make use of these variables. So this brings us to the end of this session. I hope you are a bit clearer on what we saw today. Before we wrap up, let's quickly recap what we have seen so far. So we have seen, firstly, I walked you through what are variables and their usage. Then we took a look at the properties of variable. And finally, we have seen how we can create and use a variable in a report. So that's all for this session. I hope you liked it. Let's get straight to it for more updates on the upcoming videos. Yeah. Thank you.